guys, so in this lesson, we're actually going to start using some developer tools. What we're going to do is we're going to be the developer here, and we're going to commit some code to a source code repository. So you don't have to write any code, all the code will be provided. We're just going to commit it, make a couple of changes, and we'll see how those changes then get committed and pushed through automatically by CodePipeline to Elastic Beanstalk and deployed to our Node.js application. Now, if you don't have your Node.js application running from the end of the last section, I'll quickly show you how to get it set up again. I'm in my Elastic Beanstalk console now, and as you can see, I have my Node.js application running. If you don't, click Create New Environment, choose Web Server Environment, give it an application name, I'll just call it My Node.js 2, give it an environment name, it auto fills out for you. For platform, make sure you choose Node.js, and then upload code, choose file, and choose this Node.js red from the Elastic Beanstalk folder in the course download. Click on choose, and then create environment. I'm not quite sure why it says degraded, but let's check the URL and make sure that it's running. And sure enough, the page is running here, so we've got congratulations, and we've got a red background. So what we're going to do is we're going to make some modifications to change this. I'm in the developer tools now, and the first tool that I'm going to use is CodeCommit. Now you can find the developer tools by just scrolling down to developer tools here and then choose CodeCommit. And you'll see, you still see all the services anyway on the left there because they're all very closely integrated. What we're going to do is create a repository. So this is our source code repository. I'm going to call mine My Source Repo and then click on create. So we have a repository. And there's a couple of ways we can work with it. So this is where our code goes. So how do we actually put our code there? Well, one way is to upload it, but generally you're going to use the Git client. So if you want to do that, then what you'll need to do is install Git on your machine. If you don't already have it, just go to Google and we're going to search for Git download. And then you'll see there's several different options here. You can choose Git for Windows.org or Git SCM and so on. So just check these, make sure it's a good one, and then download and install. Very simple. Back on CodeCommit, what we want to do now is we're going to clone our repository. So we can use this command here. We just copy it to our clipboard, and on a command line, I'm going to paste that in and hit enter. Now it's going to ask me for some credentials, so we need to get these credentials. So firstly, we need a username. In Identity and Access Management, you'll need to find your user account, click on it, go to Security Credentials, scroll down, and you'll see HTTPS Git Credentials for AWS CodeCommit, and then click on Generate Credentials. And this is much like generating an access key. So you can download your credentials. I'm going to copy this username, paste it in here. I'm going to copy the password, paste that in, and by the way, you don't see it, but it is there, and then hit enter. So that's fine. It tells me I've cloned an empty repository. We know it's empty, but what we'll do now is we'll copy some files into it. So you should now see that you've got this directory. So I'm going to change into that directory. And because my client is aware of Git, it will actually tell me that I'm in the master branch. So that's the main branch where we have our code. You can create multiple branches for your code. All a bit beyond this course, we're just going to add some code in and simply push it up to our repository. To do that, go to the Elastic Beanstalk folder in your course download. And what we're going to do is extract these files. We'll then go into this directory and copy all of these files. You then need to find the directory where your source code is. So wherever you cloned that repository. In my case, my source code directory is in this folder called Git. So I'm going to go in here, paste these files. And then what we're going to do is edit this HTML file. So I'm going to open it with Visual Studio Code. And we're just going to make one simple edit. We're going to come down here to where the background color says red, and we're going to change that to blue, and then click on Save. If we now come back to our command line, we can run the git status command. And we'll see that there are some uncommitted files, so these are not being tracked yet. So what we can do is run git add dot to add the files, and then git commit dash M, and we're going to say change to blue, and that's the commit message, and then we can do a git push, and this will push those changes up to our repository. So back in CodeCommit, if we just refresh this page, we'll now see that we have these files. So they've been updated in our repository and we've just pushed those from our client. We're now going to create the pipeline. So this is what's going to automate these code changes through to Elastic Beanstalk. So let's go to CodePipeline, create a pipeline. I'm going to call this My Code Pipeline 1. Click on Next. For our source provider, we choose CodeCommit. Note that you could use Bitbucket or GitHub as well as S3 here and ECR. We're going to choose CodeCommit and it will need the repository name and it finds it for us and the master branch or the name of our branch, which is master. Let's click on Next. For build provider, you could use code build. So this is for doing the build and test of your code, but we're not going to do that. You can also use Jenkins. So we're going to skip the build stage, click on skip. And then for deploy provider, there's quite a few options here, including code deploy, but we're going to go straight to Elastic Beanstalk. So that means that CodePipeline will push our changes to Elastic Beanstalk. And we can choose our application name and environment, click on next, and then just choose create pipeline. So what's going to happen now is it's going to start trying to push those changes. So we can see that CodePipeline is checking AWS CodeCommit and that's in progress. So it's going to check what changes are available. And then once it knows that there's some changes available and that's just succeeded, and we can see that the message that we put into our Git client changed to blue is shown here. And now the deploy stage is in progress. So we can see that it's trying to push those changes out to Elastic Beanstalk. So hopefully that will complete very soon. And then we should be able to refresh our page and see that it's changed the background color. So that was very quick and it has succeeded. So let's head back to the page where we've got this congratulations message. And I'm just going to refresh the page and there the background changed to blue. CodePipeline has taken the changes from CodeCommit and then pushed them through to Elastic Beanstalk. So if we wanted to change that again, we can come back here. We can literally just go in and change the background to green. Click on save. Come back to our Git client. We're going to just check that it's seen that there's a change. We can see that we've modified that file. We'll run git add, git commit dash m change to green. And then we're going to run git push. And that's going to push that change. So let's head back and see what's happening. So in CodePipeline, it's really fast. We can see it's already changed to green. And we can see that the update is now in progress on Elastic Beanstalk as well. So that's literally faster than I could change my page. It's just committed that code and now it's going to make the update to the background. So let's head over and see if it's done that yet. And that was really fast. So, you know, that was really quick and it's a great example of how you can automate the implementation of your code through continuous integration and continuous delivery. So I hope you enjoyed that, guys. And what we can do now is we can clean up this environment. In Elastic Beanstalk, we can go in and just find actions, terminate environment. And we need to copy the name of the environment from the top here and put this in and then click on terminate. We can then come back to CodePipeline, head up to pipelines, choose our pipeline, click on delete, and then we can delete this. And then if you want to delete your repository as well, you can just come up here and delete your repository. I hope you enjoyed that, guys. Now we are just scratching the surface here because there is a lot of functionality in these tools, but it's a bit beyond the scope of this course. I do want to keep it fairly simple for you. But in the next lesson, we're going to use a tool called AWS CodeStyle, and that's actually going to create a more complex configuration, and that should be quite fun. So I'll see you in that lesson.